I'll second.
Seconded by Councilman Jimenez, excuse me. His name has come out so much that I automatically say that. Seconded by Councilman Neeson. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. 5-0. Thank you so much, and we look forward to working with you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Keith, for all your hard work. Okay, moving on to item 4C. Consideration in action to adopt curfew ordinance 2018-003. This again, I will read the caption, an ordinance of the city of Forestville, Texas, on curfew for minors, establishing a curfew time of 11 p.m. through 5 a.m. for minors under the age of 16, providing for exceptions, penalties therefore, providing for a three-year review period, and establishing an effective date. Any questions by the council on this? I know our attorney has looked it over quite a few different times. If you have any questions, I know that she'd be able to answer.
And basically, Madam Mayor, I mean, this is a curfew that actually was in existence for the city of Forestville. I know that it was being enforced. And unfortunately, it lapsed up in July. So I've looked at the ordinance. I think it's a good ordinance. I actually think it's needed. I think it's a really good idea. Prior to the meeting, I spoke a little bit with Councilman Neeson because he asked last time about, you know, why is this needed? I actually looked that up, and he and I spoke a little bit about the pros and cons associated with the curfew, but I think that he and I both agree that it's a good idea. All the research, everything that I've looked at basically indicates that it's needed. It's in the best interest not only of the community, but also in the best interest of the children. Society basically believes that because of their immaturity, their young age, that they need to be at home and not out on the streets. Because when they are out on the streets, that's when problems arise.
Right. Any comments by the council? Any? I didn't see your hand up.
Well, anyway, you said on certain, I mean, there's certain things, you know, like, I know for a fact, like at Watts, on Fridays and Saturdays, some of the young kids, they'll go to the movies, and they go play basketball instead. You know, sometimes I hear them playing till 10:30, 11 o'clock. I mean, you know they're going to be back for the basketball, back to their home. I mean, like, there's not going to be a violation for that.
No, I think pretty much we even talked about that a little bit. Councilman Neeson and I did, because I could send out even a list of draft of possible exceptions and stuff of that nature. But I think the Councilman Neeson and I both agree, and I think that it's a good idea that it will be on a case-by-case basis. The police will be the enforcers, and at that time, I think that that's why you have a police force, so they can talk to the young children and ask them, are you here? If there's a legitimate reason, you have some defenses opted in the ordinance that should take that into consideration. Whether they're going from work, going from a school activity, I think those are all good reasons. And I think that that's what your law enforcement is going to be responsible for. And you have that in this ordinance.
Okay, any other comments by the council before I open the floor to the citizens? Any citizens' comments pertaining to this? If not, I will entertain a motion to approve curfew ordinance 2018-003.
I shall move.
I have a motion on the floor by Councilman Neeson to approve curfew ordinance 2018-003. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Seconded by Councilwoman Cantu. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you, 5-0. Thank you very much. Moving on to item 4D, consideration and action to approve a resolution 2018-002 in regards to disbursement criteria for the hotel tax funds. Councilman Ortiz.
Thank you, Madam Mayor, Council for staffing. Just last time we had a good discussion, this council, there was some compromise. And it was a pretty good end result. And I just want to ask council if y'all feel comfortable with it.
Yes, sir.
First of all, I want to apologize to Mr. Gonzalez because of, by no means were we trying to be disrespectful. I apologize to you, and we do appreciate everything that the board does. I guess we can table this until we get more information from the board. I think y'all are making a list or something, or...
Not a world banking.
Okay, please.
Or do you want to go ahead?
No, thank you. We can pass this one, and if they see an issue, they can come to us, and if council feels that it needs to be amended, we can work with them, but I mean, like you said, there's no disrespect. I mean, you know, we respect that they're important, you know, they're volunteer. But I just want to ask council if y'all feel comfortable with it.
Madam Mayor, okay. Yes. Just real quick, Councilman Ortiz, the resolution that is before you does allow an exception. I know while last time, or while this was, this was an issue that the board was discussing, you had discussed a $15,000 cap. However, it does allow for exceptions. There is a paragraph in there where it says, for us, the city council further wishes to establish that there will be exceptions to be considered and allowed, which may result in a higher amount being awarded.
Exactly.
So that will give an exception.
Right.
For instance, the Peanut Festival. If more money wants, if the council wants to
correct.
Say, you know what, they should be allowed more than $15,000, then that would allow that opportunity
right.
to be considered until so that
they would come before us and explain to us why.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to point
yes.
that out in the resolution.
Yes,
Councilman.
I guess, can I address Mr. Gonzalez? What the
concern
Council,
was? Can you use your
Can we get Mr. Gonzalez to come up so that way he could address maybe what his concern was?
Yes, Mr. Gonzalez.
If we have to table it, we can. If not, you know.
Mr. Gonzalez, thank you for coming up and talking to us.
Thank you. Now, what is it that I can say?
No, you said you had a major concern on how this was handled or whatever. We discussed this at the prior meeting, and we had come up with some numbers and solutions for it, and I don't know if you're aware of that.
I in what I said to you earlier is just exactly what I meant, in that generally when you're doing something like this and you're changing something that's applicable to somebody in our level, we normally get a chance to participate or input so that we can understand from the very beginning whether it's workable or not, how do we work it, and so on. For example, right now, the Peanut Festival Association came in last night. We looked at the request. We recommend a certain amount, but we had no idea what it is that you're doing and how it might affect what you were doing that night. And we've been brought in, I would be aware of it, they would be aware of it, and maybe we could work with them, whatever it is you've got. Frankly, I don't even know. Now, I know you're trying to put limits on what we can spend, and that's fine. But why not, you know, bring it to us or vice versa? We're available at any time, I am personally, and we can input, work with you, help you, and then we can own part of what we're gonna do. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, sir, but I don't know if you were here last meeting. We discussed this and we came up with a dollar amount and exceptions to the rule. That, for example, Peanut Festival, we normally give X amount of dollars from, and that's over $10,000, $15,000, whatever the stipulation, $15,000. So there's exceptions for something. What I'm merely asking, is there something different that you think that needs to be in there, that we need to table this, or are you satisfied with how it's going?
I guess we're not really communicating here. I'm concerned about the way you went about it. It's already a done deal pretty much. What can we do now at this point? Besides, what can we input on that we don't know about? You know, I mean, see, all I've heard from you folks is that you're gonna put a limit, and it might be 15, it might be 10, and then there is flexibility on that. But is that it? Just a line up here? Is that what it is? I don't understand.
Well,
I would think that what do you call it, a resolution?
Yes, sir.
A resolution has more to it than that. Again, you know, you folks are the ones that control what can be or will be spent. I have no problem with that. But we're technical evaluators to make sure that by the time that you look at it, we've made every, what is it, vetting on it to assure, first of all, that it technically, legally meets the requirements to be paid or granted. And so we do, I think, at least on my part, and last night we did a great job. We do a very good look-see. We apply the criteria. We make sure that by the time you get it, you can have it, you can grow it. Now, if you don't want to give that amount, you want to lower it, time, you want to give more, I have a question. And I would like to comment on that and ask, why are we doing that? You know, our review, which I think is very meticulous and somewhat technical, you know, it should be pretty good at least on the top limit. Now, on the bottom limit, it's up to you.
Hold on, Councilman Jimenez. Yes. Councilman Nissen's been waiting to ask a question.
I see you're talking about, and I say out of respect to it, I agree with you. But out of respect to the jurisdiction board, I would like to table this and sit down with the tourism and visitors board or Ms. Ortiz to explain the reasons that they're solid and to get your input in on it, because they are the governing body of that to come to us. And I really believe that we rely on, and I believe out of respect we should stay with, go to their, put it on their next agenda and go sit down with them and see their feelings and see how they go before we make an ordinance, so we don't have to change it. We do it once, then it stays that way.
No. My question was to the part of the board that if this was satisfactory enough for you, or is there, do you have a change that you would like to do before we have to table this or not?
Yes.
That's what I'm ready to say.
Let me again say this. I'm here as a member, not necessarily representing the board's view. I think they don't disagree with what I said earlier, but I'm here as a member of the board. I do not speak for them at this point. Now, you keep saying, are you all right with what you have? What do you have?
Well, there's a resolution that says there's a $15,000 limit on the monies that are dispersed, and there's also a clause in there that if we need to go over $15,000 or to make an exception to the rule, but like for example the Peanut Festival, which you know, and I don't know yet until you bring it in front of us, that it's over $15,000.
No, so I'm telling you the figure right now if you want it.
No, I don't need it right now.
I can do it. We're recommending 27.
Okay, so that's an exception.
Right.
Okay, so all of, you know, the resolution to me sounds fine, sounds great, but if there was anything, you shared your concern that you were notified, but you know, we talked about it last meeting, and that's what I was saying. That's really what I was saying. So
if all you're talking about is a limit without any explanations or whatever, and no in-depth or substantive reasoning for it, that's fine. But be aware that just an arbitrary line creates a problem for us. I think, I really believe this, and this is me personally, and I'm working very hard in there. I think we can handle the controlling of the expenditures and properly so without arbitrarily putting a line on how much we can spend. Now, if you want to do it, that's fine with me. My message to you was that, and I've been a manager many years ago too, and always, you know, when we're affecting a particular party that works for us, so to speak, we try to get their input so that we can work together and it becomes our house. We own it from the bottom and the top. And that was all, just a complaint.
Councilman Nissen, get your hand up.
Yeah. Explained what he said. He said it basically true, but to get your true just, it's a yearly cap for each award of $15,000. So it's, if they come back two or three times, that's fine. We still want to go over 15,000. Say a boat show comes and he wants to put a boat show on, another boat, we want to keep it at 15, with exceptions. So if you see the boat show first time was great, and he can come back and he can do more, that's up to you to say, yes, we want to give him 15,000 for this time, because they're bringing all these people to heads to beds. And we talked about the heads to beds on a daily basis, and so that's still going to be up to you. Mm-hmm. The only thing this really...
So we don't take all your night here. We understand, you know, all that we do, and I think it's important, and you, in essence, pretty much reflected that, actually, when you were saying, and very rightly so, Councilman Menace, that when they got to you, they gave you nothing. Nothing you could put your arms around, and it made it very difficult, because you arbitrarily then had to make a decision. And I agree with you. I don't think you have that situation.
No. It's the ultimate thing is y'all. Y'all bring, y'all present to us. And, right. But we're just saying that there will be some exceptions, okay, and y'all are going to do it.
I think what we're trying to decide here is, and I understand what Mr. Gonzalez and the whole board is coming from. You had a meeting last night, and then this is presented
a little bit late.
A little bit late, so you got to, you know.
We can deal with that, because we're grandfather, I would think, on that one, since we didn't get it.
Right. Right.
Mayor, I was here last night, but I wasn't in that meeting. I was over here. One of the things, and I had a conversation with Councilman Ortiz, is that it's changed. And so, you know, I can't tell the board it was 10 to 15, and there was limited time. So we just need to have what direction you're looking at. And then, if you would mind, if you want to sign the table tonight, we can take them on their agenda for next time. They can make their comments and then come back to you about their concerns. But it was, the number went from 10 to 5, to, it was not, so I can't go as staff and say, this is what the council's thinking about, because I didn't know what you all had ultimately agreed on. So if you could let your attorney know, this is generally what you're thinking about, if you want to tweak anything, then we can present to them, and Mr. Gonzalez will read every word of it, I guarantee you. And get back and put it on the agenda, then maybe we can come and have more productive with their concerns and or questions. Is that fair?
Right. And when is your next meeting?
We have one next month. It's on the third Wednesday of the month for regular meetings, what we can call a special meeting. In fact, last night I'm asking our chairperson, I'm not the chairperson, to have a special meeting, and I would hope within a couple of weeks. But again, you know, like last night in the one with the Opry, they come in with 15, we go 9. And properly looking at it, you know, and putting numbers together and so on, and being mindful that we only have a limited amount. Last night we had a request for 35, we came up with 27. And by the same process, I would venture to say, based on my experience from a year or 2 years ago, and what I see coming up, that $15,000 limit is probably not going to be exceeded. Rare exception, I don't foresee.
Their next regular meeting is the 21st of March.
Okay. I'm going to try to get them to have one prior to that, because we've got some things we need to resolve for internal operations. And then I think we're going to ask you to review the bylaws.
Yes, I did get that.
So we should have one within a couple of weeks. And again, you know, my message to you was simply future. When we do things, you know, we would appreciate this kind of thing. This is really not a big deal, very frankly, from my standpoint, because I think we can handle it at our level.
Okay, with that said, I'll give the seat to Mr. Gonzalez for him to get his board and come to us, and let me see what we can fix. I mean, you know, my opinion, we are policymakers. We set the tone. But with this said, being said, we'll work with the board.
Councilman Ortiz, let me again say, we respond to you guys. So if you want us to look at something, give us something, and we'll respond to it.
Well, I've said it, and Councilman Jimenez said it too. There's a gap there, but if y'all feel...
It's a matter of procedure, Mr. Ortiz, a matter of how you deal with us. That's all. I'm not making myself clear, that's okay, I'm just a person.
I'll make a motion to...
And I'll do my job as well as I've always done it, regardless of what you say.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, Councilman Ortiz, you have any motion on the floor? Okay, there's a motion on the floor to table item 4D. Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
Seconded by Councilman Mason. All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
Four.
Okay, I'm looking at all those in favor of table.
I made a motion.
Yeah, he made the motion, this is all five.
Yeah, it's just that some pants didn't go up. Okay. All right, we are going to table that, and Mr. Gonzalez, I know that you'll let us know when your board has their next meeting.
Can I ask a question?
Just very quickly, yes. I'll let you know, first of all, I've got to talk to my chairperson, and then let you know prior to that so that you can give us whatever it is you want us to look at. And we'll be glad to look at it, and we'll be glad to respond to it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Councilman Cantu, did you have a question?
Yes, I wanted to ask you, on the, that we just tabled, Mr. Nissan said, or that every time they could come more than once for the $15,000?
No. They can come more than one time, but the max they can come for the year was $15,000, yes.
Unless...
There's an exception that he says the first time was super successful, we want to give more, they filled in 20 rooms or something like that, then you can go over. But for him just to come and run, and I'm just picking on boat show, whatever, if you want a boat call, it's whole different. Boat show this month, they want to do another for a boat show, they want to do another for a boat show, they have a show come around $5,000, $10,000. The max they can get is $15,000, unless they can prove to them that more.
Okay. All right, with no other items on the agenda, this meeting is now adjourned at 8:26.